And I don't get it. Because Google Translate doesn't translate everything, unfortunately. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to another Let's Talk Makeup, new makeup releases. And if you are new here, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 43. I'm from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And yeah, today is Let's Talk Makeup New Releases Day. Let me tell you a little bit about that if you are new. This is just my way of talking about new makeup releases, basically. It is kind of based like Will I Buy It from Samantha March. Her playlist will be down below, but she was also kind enough to create a community playlist where creators such as myself can add these types of videos to, which I do every time I upload it, which is usually every Sunday. Okay, that is kind of the household. Oh no, I have a little bit more of household messages. The look I have, I did film, well, sort of. I filmed that, except the lippy. I changed the lippy to match my shirt. So yeah, I did that, but the look I filmed, it is not up yet. It should be up this week. I'm not entirely sure when. I think maybe it will even be a bonus video, because it is actually the try on part one of my birthday haul. Part two is coming, because this morning I saw that one of our Dutch kind of like, it's like Sephora, but then Dutch based, I don't know. Anyway, Issy Paris is having a sale, 40% off of their palettes. They also carry Jeffree Star. So I ordered the Alien palette this morning on sale. And yeah, it is actually part of my birthday haul, because I hauled it from, or I paid with it using the birthday gift cards. I'm rambling and it's really annoying. Anyway, that one is coming as well, so there will be a part two. The lippy I have, the Eye Look is Tribe palette, by the way. The lippy I have is this one from Catrice. And the Generation Matte in the color 030 Exotic Rebel. And what I want to do though, I need to film it and I hope to have it up this week as probably an extra bonus video, is swatch all the new lip colors. I have them all, there are 10. Of their new generation matte liquid lipsticks. I have all 10 and I will do a swatch video. It will probably just be just a quick video in between, you know, like that. So if you want to get the shades, you kind of know what they look like and maybe which one is your favorite. So let me know down below if that is of interest to you. For now, let's just kind of stop rambling. Let me go to the side. Oh yeah, the products I mentioned today will be down in my description box, as are some, well, discount codes if you're interested. My sources are also down there, and I always have shoutouts in my description box, and the shoutouts are actually, well, always the same, because it's my beauty YouTubers growth group. Well, it's not technically mine, but I am a part of it. We are just, you know, some small channels that help support each other. We are all in that collective. It's almost like a cult. Almost. Yes, but their channels are all listed down below, so go check them out. I'm going to the side so I can plop up pictures and maybe videos of what I'm going to talk about. I actually don't really have a lot, I feel. Or at least, yeah, there was quite a few things that came out, but not really much that kind of grabbed my attention. So let me go to my saved folder on Instagram. The first one is kind of a message. And it is actually from Certify. I saw this kind of floating around on the internet and I want to mention it because it's this. I don't know if you can read what it says, but I will read it for you. It is, well, it's basically a mail. It says hi and then your name. And then it says, I'm Sarah from Certify's marketing team. We've been wanting to expand blah, blah, blah. Let me tell you something about Certify. They don't have a marketing team. At least not as far as I know, because she does it all by herself. The mail is fake. So please, if you get an email from Certify saying, well, telling you that they want you in their affiliate program or anything like that at all, please, please contact Certify, because the mail is fake. But yeah, you know, if they are doing it for Certify, maybe they are doing it for other brands as well. So if you get an email, something like this from a brand, saying that they want you to be in their affiliate program, please contact the brand and do not, for the love of all that is holy, give your personal information just you know? So please always check and make sure that your information is in safe hands. Let me get a sip of... Makeup is drugstore first. I don't have mainstream today, I think. No, because there wasn't really anything that interests me. So let's start with essence. I saw this. It says, make your dreams come true and plan your next steps with our new diary. It comes with 20 amazing eyeshadows, 2 highlighters, 2 contouring shades and 2 blushes. So you're always ready and prepared, even on the go. I don't know if it's practical, but it is different. You know, I actually kind of like it. Is it practical? Probably not. It maybe if you want to do your makeup on the toilet where you have your calendar. I don't know. I have my calendar on the toilet. Am I the only one? Let's move on. So let's go to Makeup Revolution next. You see here a little film, and that is because I like the film. So that's why I plopped the movie in. This, it says, the new classic, meet the vintage lace highlighter palette filled with 4 richly pigmented shades of opal, pale yellow gold, rose gold and bronze with subtle glitter and 3D lace embossing running throughout. This cream to powder formula, oh, glued onto the skin, what? Wait, what? This cream to powder formula glued onto the skin, leaving a gorgeous glow on cheekbones, the bridge of your nose and inner corners. Get that glow for £8, €8.99 or $10 at revolutionbeauty.com and Superdrug. So it is a cream to powder, apparently. I think the tops are sprayed and I think that's a shame. So what I can see on the movie that you see playing here is that when they open it, you see that nice duochrome-y glittery effect, that shiny effect. But it looks like that when she or he puts their finger over it, it's just a top layer. And I think that's a shame. Because I was kind of liking this. Yeah, it looks like she's rubbing off the top layer, which is a shame. So I want to see reviews of this first, actually, because I want to know if it is a sprayed or if it is, you know, the multicolored throughout. I think the only the top layer is though, which I think is a shame. I think that's a shame. But yeah, anyway, I was actually really interested, but now I'm kind of less interested, to be totally honest with you. So let's move on to the next one. The next one is also from Revolution. It is a foil frenzy creation. This one swipe wonder palette is filled with 15 rich shades that pack a punch. The intensity of these eyeshadows lies in its extraordinary formula, in which the pigment is poured, not pressed. And I don't get it. But let me tell you what it retails for. £8. €8.99 and $10 at Superdrug and Revolution Beauty. I already saw this online though. But I have no idea what the difference is between a poured versus a pressed pigment. And to be honest, I wasn't interested in it until I read that it is poured. Because now I kind of want to know what the difference is. Do I make sense? And I see a red shimmer. Still on the lookout for a red shimmer. So maybe? I don't know. Let me know what you think. Let's go to ColourPop. And I was actually quite, well, kind of pissed off about this, to be quite honest with you. I placed an order at ColourPop. My first ColourPop order for some of the mascaras. They had a sale going on, you know, all that goodness. I think it was even... I got some discount for my birthday. I don't remember. But anyway, I placed an order for mascaras. I also got the purple palette. The Ula, no? My precious. I know. The purpley palette. I got that one as well. And then I actually saw this pop up. I saw the sneak peek of it. I think it was 2 days after I made the order. And I thought, oh, that's actually quite a bummer. Because, yeah. I do have some of these types of eyeliners. I needed to think about what the word was again. Eyeliners from Essence and they aren't really that good. I'm curious to see if these are good. Do I know what they will retail for? Oh yeah, they're $8 each. You can get the liner PR set for 56. And if you have a liner and a mascara duo, it's 15 with code BFF goals. But basically it is a mascara. No, basically it is an eyeliner to complement the corresponding mascara. That's basically what they did. So yeah, just so you know. Oh, what am I doing? I don't know what am I doing. Anyway, let me know if you have picked them up, if you are going to pick them up, you know, that kind of thing. I'm going to wait though. So let's move on to indie and let's start with Babybed Beauty. Babybed Beauty has released yesterday. Yes, I think so. I think it was yesterday. A limited edition. Where did I have it? Oh yeah, a limited collection inspired by flowers and the spring season. They have free shipping on US orders above $35 and international orders above $75. They have released, let's start with eyes. So they have released five new eyeshadows. And you see them here. They're vegan and cruelty free. And I hope that my editing self has plopped everything on one picture. Picture there, yes. So you see the eyeshadows. They also released four highlighter shades. And those were in the square. The eyes are the eyeshadows. The square is the highlighters. You see the swatch. If you where the name is on the picture of the highlighter, that's the swatch. That's what I wanted to say. It's difficult to talk today. And then they released two lippies. And the eyeshadows are pretty. And I think that the highlighters are pretty too. It's just not something that I would use as a highlighter. Well, yeah, in a corner highlight, but not as a face highlighter. Let me know if you have ordered anything from them and yeah, how the quality is and all that goodness. Let's go to Medusa Makeup. Medusa's Makeup, actually. Because I have two sneak peeks of new launches coming this spring. These are, what are these? Liquid eyeshadows. So here you see the swatches of the liquid eyeshadows. That blue is really popping, isn't it? Yeah. Anyway. Yeah. And you see a picture of blush, highlight, and bronzer in their new packaging. And I think the packaging is really cute. And it kind of, you know, it kind of says what it is as well. So the sweet cheeks, well, duh. That's obviously a bronzer. And then some. No, but you know, I think it's fun. I think the packaging is cute. Oh, yeah, and I almost forgot. You see the swatches of the blush and highlighter shades as well. So, yeah, I think that it looks pretty, basically. I just wanted to show you. I don't know. It's launching in March, and that's all I know. Okay, let's go to Root Cosmetics because Root Cosmetics are. They posted these. I don't know when they are coming though. Oh, dropping very soon. So, Root Cosmetics is dropping Pro Palettes very soon. Please sit down for this. It's an essential assortment of beautiful mattes, bold glittery shimmers, and gorgeous brights that are specifically formulated for professional makeup artistry. Remember that professional makeup artistry, yes? Don't struggle with big palettes. Our palettes are small in size to fit any makeup bag and are perfect to travel for work with plenty of shades to choose from. Made to be universal, any look can be made on any skin tone. The Pro Balloon eyeshadows contain 16 unique shades. And the Pro Butterflies, which is blush, highlight, and contour, contains 16 universal shades. Let me plop in the pictures of how they look. You see, you saw the outside while I was talking, obviously, and now you can see them splayed out underneath each other. So, yeah. I do have to say, if you are not someone who has a YouTube channel, and someone who just wants to, I don't know, grab one palette for everything, this could be for you as well. You know, if I didn't have a YouTube channel and I saw this, I would, I think I would be interested, especially the eyeshadows, because you have actually everything that you need. Colors, neutrals. So I don't think this is such a weird release. It is not practical for us YouTubers, but I think there are a lot of people who will like this release, to be very honest with you. Let's go to XNO Cosmetics, or XNO. I always say XNO, I don't know why, but they showed this. You see the palette and the swatches of the brand new XNO Cosmetics Matte About You palette. 15 matte colors, and it is available now. It does not say what it will retail for, because of course not. It's not for me. And in this, you know, this is why I like swatches, because when I look at the palette, especially the bottom row, I'm like, what's the color difference between them? But that's also because I look at them on a screen, you know? So when I then see the swatches, I can see, oh, okay, so one is a bit more orange, one is a bit more pink, one is a bit more yellow. Especially if you have, you know, kind of like a blue light filter over your screen, it can kind of, yeah, make the colors a bit wonky. So that's why I also like swatches, just to see how the colors are, what kind of colors the colors are. But yeah, this is not for me. I do have to say though that I actually thought that the browns in there were a different color. The browns are actually okay. I'm not hating the neutral row. I'm not going to get it, but I don't hate it. And that's also, I prefer in my palettes a mix of shimmer and mattes. That's what I prefer. But yeah, let me know if you are interested. Yeah. Next, I saw from Rani Cosmetics, Rani, in Dutch we would say Rani Cosmetics. It says, it's here, be one of the very first to get your hands on our brand new Shattered Gems eyeshadow palette. It looks pretty, but then I went to, I actually check it out, and then I saw the price, and I was like, well, I don't know this brand, so I'm going to wait a bit. And if I was not mistaken, it retailed for, what was it, $48? Let me check real quick. Yes, so, you know, it retails for $48, and I'm not saying that it is not worth it. I'm just saying I don't know the brand, and so it is not worth it to me at this moment in time. Does that make any sense? Let me know if it's worth it to you, if you are getting this. And you know, I'm going to wait for reviews, because yeah, while I think it's really, really pretty, it does not grab me enough to pay that amount of money for it, especially for a brand that I don't know. So yeah, that's basically it. Next is Menagerie Cosmetics. Let me go to the side again, because I'm drifting to the center. She showed this sneak peek. It's from their Camouflage Soft Focus Liquid Concealer and Setting Powder. A new and innovative concealing duo that conceals, heals and protects your delicate skin. We named these two products after Master of Disguise the Chameleon. There are also some featured ingredients in here. Green tea, which is anti-inflammatory and improves and protects skin from free radicals. But green tea is known for that. Hyaluronic acid, which is a super moisturizer. Algae extract instantly hydrates skin, high in antioxidants and anti-aging properties. Aloe vera, which is an excellent moisturizer, and it soothes and heals irritated skin. It's fantastic though. Fantastic on burns as well. And caffeine to depuff under eye and reduce dark circles. The Soft Focus Liquid Concealer will retail $24. And the setting powder will retail for $22. I don't actually think that $24 is high this day and age. Well, it is high for me. You know, to be quite honest, the most expensive concealer I have in my collection is one from Nabla. And I think that retails for, I don't remember what that retails for, $15? Euros? Something along those lines? I don't know. But yeah, so it is quite pricey. I do like this though. I, you know, I really, really like the brand. I like Menagerie Cosmetics a lot. And that is, it's also because I like the brand that much, I am willing to also kind of go the extra mile. Does that make any sense? I am going to wait for reviews because it is not just this price, but it is also around $22, something along those lines, I think. Say 20 euros, I'm not sure, to ship it from the US to me. And yeah, you know, for me to want to do that and take the risk that I need to pay import tax on top of that as well, I want to make a bigger order. So I know she's going to release eyeshadow palettes. She sneak peeked the Whale Song last year, pictures of that. She also sneak peeked, was it the Flamingo Love palette? Or something along those lines. You know, so I know she's coming out with eyeshadow palettes, and then I will probably do one bigger order and get multiple things in once. Does that make any sense? But I'm really interested in this, and I actually cannot wait to see reviews on it. Okay, I have here Sigil Inspired. So I will show you a few pictures. The first picture I saw was the drawing of the woman holding the chicken. Let me... See, I'm glad that she put it in English this time because she's based in Russia. She's a Russian indie brand and she specializes in loose pigments and they are gorgeous. It says, good morning with a new matte collection. Red Viburnum. Wait, let me translate. On the snow, Kalina Red? I don't know. Red something on the snow. I don't know. 18 new and interesting matte colors about the last days of winter in the colors of the last blue snow, sunset, and the drinks of last year's berries. I think that's how you need to, you know, share your impressions and we in turn will show new ones in details. Her worldwide is Etsy store, but you can also order from her Russian-based site. You just have to read Russian then, because Google Translate doesn't translate everything, unfortunately. But yeah, you see here the colors as well, and I like them all. And to be quite honest with you, the one that I like the most, the one that speaks to me the most, is the one, the darker one. So I don't know where I have put it. It is dark red and a bit brown and the color of blood, to be honest. And berries, blood and berries, yes. But anyway, those really, really speak to me. Go check out this brand. I think that was it, by the way. So yeah, that was the last thing. Yeah, guys, this was it. This was it for me. For this week's Let's Talk Makeup, new makeup releases. Let me know down below what you think about the products that I talked about today. Maybe I missed some things. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram, and if you see anything interesting, tag me on Instagram as well, so that I can talk about that next week in next week's episode. Yeah, that was, yeah, it's still fabulous weather outside. So what I'm going to do is sign off. Don't forget to give the video a thumbs up if you liked it. Yes, and leave a comment down below. It helps me tremendously. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fantastic evening, depending on when and where you are watching. And I hope to see you in my next one. Bye, guys.